chief, they are in argument with Swati Maliwal, the former DCW chief and current...
Well, Swati Maliwal is coming out right now also. Tejshree, we are looking at those pictures. Mega, mega exclusive pictures that we are looking at. And this is how, in fact, when it comes to Swati Maliwal, who was taken to the court there to record her statement in front of the judicial statement, the judicial magistrate there, you can see she is barely able to walk probably down the stairs. She's taking one step at a time. And you can see the condition in which Swati Maliwal currently is in. She has been talking about a traumatic, the last 2-3 days has been for her. She can barely walk properly. And this, in fact, tells you about the ordeal that she had mentioned in the FIR with the police, that she was beaten up, she was slapped, she was kicked. She was slapped multiple times on her head, on her stomach, in the lower part of her body, and she is even barely able to walk. She was coming down the stairs one step at a time, and this is the condition in which, properly for the first time, that we are looking at Swati Maliwal. Coming hours later, when she also underwent the medical checkup at the All India Institute of Medical Sciences, she gave a detailed statement to the police, and thereafter FIR was registered. The police itself has been now at the residence of the Chief Minister, and here is Swati Maliwal in this current condition, that you can see that she is barely able to walk properly. She has now just recorded her statement in front of the judicial magistrate, and almost, as you can see, the questions that are being asked to her, but right now she is traumatized. She is not in a condition to speak, as it can be clearly seen in those pictures there, as she's coming out from the court after recording her statement. This is big. This is big. For the first time, properly, we are getting to see Swati Maliwal in that condition, and she is barely able to walk. She has been talking about her ordeal. She has been talking about how painful it was for her, that she was attacked unprovoked. She was slapped. She was kicked. She was dragged. And all of this happened at the residence of the Delhi Chief Minister. She was crying for help. Nobody came. And thereafter, she made the distress call to the police and went to the police station. But she was not in such kind of a state of mind where she would have filed a formal complaint. She took some time. And after that, we're looking at a lot of convincing that the Delhi police team that reached her residence. And for the first time, we are looking at Swati Maliwal right now. On the other side, the feed that you're looking at right now, this is at the drawing room of where this incident happened, where Swati Maliwal was assaulted. Tejshree, we're looking at the inside pictures there, exactly when it comes to the team. Who is this team inside Delhi Chief Minister's drawing room, where we are told that the assault happened with Swati Maliwal? Who all are there in these pictures?
Well, it seems like they are the security. This is the security team from Arvind Kejriwal's residence itself. And it, in fact, you know, takes to that particular incident mentioned in the FIR when Vibhav Kumar called the security. So it seems like it is highly, it is most likely that particular portion when Vibhav Kumar must have called the security to ask her to leave the residence, because she can be heard saying that I will dial 112 from this particular place. She's there. The arguments can be seen with the guards, where they say that no, you cannot dial it from here, and that is what she has said in her FIR also, in her statement also, that I requested them to sit here, to be there till the time PCR van comes, but they denied, and they kept on asking me to leave the residence, to leave the premises no matter what. I came out running, sat there for 5 minutes, but this particular video, this particular footage inside the Chief Minister's residence will be certainly one of the most important evidence also for the police as far as investigation is concerned. Yes, of course, police will be investigating the CCTV cameras inside the Chief Minister's residence premises as well. But this is the CCTV footage inside the drawing room playing on our TV screens that shows that the security guards are present inside the drawing room and asking Swati Maliwal to leave from that particular drawing room. But she says very much adamantly that I will be dialing 112. No matter what, and that you dare not touch me. She wants the guards also to protect herself. Remember that she has mentioned in her statement that I several times pleaded to Vibhav Kumar to not to assault me, to stop assaulting me, to stop threatening me, and in fact pleaded for help. So then if she had pleaded for help, then at that point of time, where were the security guard? This is the big question right now.
Right now, we are looking at those visuals there. So this video is said to be purportedly on that very day itself when the assault happened. on Swati Maliwal. This is inside the very same drawing room of the chief minister's residence. And this is probably an altercation that seems to be happening there. But till now, Priyank, importantly, when it comes to breaking down the sequence of events, right now, as far as Swati Maliwal is concerned and the police investigation, because we are told they will be looking at every angle, the CCTV footage and also the people involved.
Yes, Sandy, and it's another mega time star news break where you can see the assault happening. So this is the exclusive visual of the Sheesh Mahal assault gate, which has been accessed by our team of reporters in Times at Work. This is certainly important to be seen that how Swati Maliwal's claim can be substantiated. This particular claim is also important because if you see, there are people surrounding Swati Maliwal. This is also narrating what she had said. But what Swati Maliwal had also claimed is also being substantiated by particular claim. While looking at the video, look at the visuals of the inside visuals of Sheesh Mahal. There's a man who's wearing this denim loafers who has shot this particular video. There's a man who wanted to highlight what was happening there inside the CM's bungalow here in the national capital, which is the 6th flagship road. There you can see that the visual where Swati Maliwal can be sitting, seen sitting on the sofa. There are the people of the Delhi police team, security wing, who are trying to convince Swati Maliwal to leave from there. So the visual evidence is Sati claiming that Swati Maliwal was present inside this particular mansion of Arvind Kejriwal. And right, it is also important that the Delhi police will also be recording a statement of all these security personnel of the Delhi police who were deployed on duty.
Certainly, but Priyank, what do we make of this video? Is it before or after the assault had happened?
Can you please repeat your question?
Is it before or after the alleged assault that had happened?
That is a matter of subject to investigation because what it claims that once Swati Maliwal had gone to the CM's official residence, because at this flagship road, the CM's bungalow is also situated and his camp office is also present there. So this incident is certainly before the assault could have happened. This is the claim, the 52-second video is a claim from the Aam Aadmi Party side that Swati Maliwal was not assaulted. She was sitting on the couch, but they have not shared that particular sequence where it proved that, yes, there was a verbal altercation, which later on led to assault on the Aam Aadmi Party MLA, which has led to filing of an FIR under CRPC section 354B, which is a non-bailable section. As Bhaktosh has also stated to our viewers that the legal team of Vibhav Kumar is trying to seek a non-bailable warrant. And this is a claim which has come out after the counterclaim from Swati Maliwal that she was assaulted inside the residence of Delhi Chief Minister. So the 52-second video is certainly a claim from the Aam Aadmi Party side that the security staff was trying to convince Swati Maliwal to leave, but she was not agreeing to do so.
Right. We've done a basic translation, as you can see, of what this heated argument could be all about. Purportedly, this video said to be on the same day when the alleged assault happened at the chief minister's residence. Swati Maliwal there could be seen there sitting on that sofa, and there is an entire staff that seems to be surrounding her. And basically, on your screens, we have the translation of what we could make out from the video clip that could have happened on that same day. We are still not sure if the assault had already happened or it was before that. But here is said to be a clip exclusively of that very day itself. Where is Swati Maliwal now, Priyank? Any update on that? Because we are looking at several other angles as well. For the first time, we had a good look at Swati Maliwal right now for the first time ever since this incident. But we just have to head into a short break. Lot of breaking updates, lot of exclusive details only on Times Now. This is a non-stop live coverage.